Ashley, you graduated from the Central School of Speech and Drama at the University of London. Can you please tell more about what is stage director?
Well, I would say that the role of the stage director, especially working in opera, is, there are two roles. Firstly, interpretation, and secondly, coordination. So regarding interpretation, we have a great number of works of art, masterpieces from composers from the last 350 years, some of which were composers who were famous in their own lifetimes, some that their work was only became relevant to us after mm-hmm. their death. Now these works of art, if they are not performed, if they are not seen in the way that their composers intended, then they will be lost to us, or they will lie forgotten until later generations. So that is the first job of a stage director, is to firstly approach it from the point of view of the audience, to create something exciting, something interesting and invigorating for them that is attractive, but also to look at it from the point of view of the composer, to even 300 years after a piece was composed, to try to find out, to pinpoint exactly what the composer wanted to convey to an audience. Mm. The world is very different now than it was 300 years ago, and we have very different ways of telling stories. So if you approach it from the audience and from the composer's point of view, then as that meets, that's what makes a production. The second thing is coordination. You mentioned my training at the Central School of Speech and Drama. I was an actor before, so I moved from acting to directing plays and ensembles through to directing opera. Now, opera is a very exciting thing to work in as a director, because it is the combination of many art forms. It's the culmination of acting, singing, performing, music, dance, choreography, design, costumes, architecture. So the coordination of those things to make a production is the technical part of it. So I would say those are the two main areas.
Yeah, very exciting.
Mm-hmm.
So this is your first time at Operosa Festival. The question is, were there any challenges for you working on the opera Iolanta? If they were, what?
Right, okay, well, I'd say that the main challenges, the main challenge actually is the venue. It's a very exciting challenge, because on one hand, this opera is perfect to do in this venue in Candicula in Herceg-Novi, because it is about a blind princess who is, it's a little bit like a fairy tale, a blind princess who is kept secret, hidden by her father in a protected, fortified place in the mountains and forests. So it is a perfect venue for the opera itself. However, this is not a theatre, you know. Mm. This is not a traditional opera house.
Yes.
So there is no orchestra pit or lights, or and sometimes it's quite difficult to make something site specific mm-hmm. in this way. But those are our challenges, and we're getting there. And I think by the time we finish, we will have created something unique. And that's the exciting thing about doing this specific opera in this specific venue. It will never happen again, so it's unique.
Yeah. How does the typical day of stage director look like?
Well, the great thing about that is that there is no typical day for a stage director. The process can be very long. It can be up to a year that you are working on a production. The first section is about working out what's the best way to present it, then working out what your resources are, and then how you're going to present it. And then you move into rehearsals, and then up the sharp end, the technical rehearsals. So it's dealing with a lot of different groups of people. So it never gets boring. Yeah.
Can you remember the craziest thing that ever happened to you during the production?
Well, crazy and unexpected is not great when we're working in opera, because what we want to do is create things that are expected. Yes, because of the amount of planning that's involved, unexpected things are not always welcome. But I would say, well, actually, there was one production that we did a long time ago where when the cast arrived, none of them knew each other. And when we finished the production, two of them got married a month later. So the chemistry, we must have got the chemistry right in that production. Yeah.
What are you the most curious about today?
Well, okay. Well, at the moment, I would say it's this production. It's this opera. It's this opera. In Western Europe, I'm from Britain. This Tchaikovsky's Iolanta is not performed as much as his other masterpieces, like Eugene Onegin or Pique Dame, Queen of Spades. So it is a great opportunity for me to really delve in to find what is so special about this piece. And there is plenty that is special about it. This is Tchaikovsky's last opera. Mm-hmm. So it is a place where it's a time when he was at the master of drama and music. And the more that this piece is performed, I think people will realize that it has some extraordinary drama and music in it. So yes, that's what I'm obsessed with at the moment. Yeah.
And the last question. What makes a day a good day for you?
Well, it depends. It depends what we're doing. At the moment, we're in the middle of stage and orchestras. So we've got lights, orchestra, performing, design. Everybody's trying to do everything at the same time. So it's at the moment, it's difficult to see the final result. But even though it may not look like it's all coming together. It takes a keen eye to see that things are actually progressing. But so sometimes it may not look like that, but you have to think carefully about the progress that you're making. And I think we're making good progress on this one.
Great. Thank you very much for the conversation.
Thank you. Thanks.